Hello and welcome. I'm Sanjay Pinto. For 20 years, a man is in prison for a role he played in the assassination of a former prime minister. The Supreme Court, the highest court of the country, sentenced him to death. But like any convict, he is entitled to be heard for clemency by the President of India. Now, after a substantial delay, a delay of many, many years, the verdict to hang him has evoked an emotional appeal. A cry from the heart from the convict's mother. The prime of her son's life, she says, has been spent in prison. Should there be a time frame for mercy petitions to be decided? Is the president's decision subject to judicial review? Does Per Ariwalan deserve mercy? On The Big Question tonight, we are joined live by his mother, Arputamal, the former CBI chief investigating officer in the case, Raghothaman, former headquarters secretary of the Tamil Nadu Congress, America V. Narayanan, and A. Subramani, a senior journalist on the legal beat and now a practicing advocate in the Madras High Court. But all that and more in a very short while from now after the headlines with Ashmit Kumar. Ashmit?
Thanks a lot, Sanjay. Let's take a look at the top stories at this hour. The mother of Per Ariwalan, sentenced to death for his role in making of the belt bomb that killed former Prime Minister Rajiv Gandhi, says the delay in the rejection of the clemency plea is unfair to challenge it in court. A Bangalore court rejects Chief Minister Jayalalitha's plea to dispense with her personal appearance in the wealth case, but Amma can appeal in the High Court. Mild tremors 3.5 on the Richter scale with Arayur as the epicenter shook 5 districts in the state this morning. Unrest in Perambalur after an engineering student commits suicide, alleging harassment by his teacher. Engineering colleges in the vicinity to stay shut for 4 days. 50,000 workers in Chennai's industrial complex to get new welfare schemes, a part of corporate social responsibility. A very good evening and welcome to the show. Let's take a look at top developments that are making headlines across the country. Two policemen caught on camera shooting at fleeing farmers on the Mumbai-Pune highway are suspended. British Prime Minister David Cameron explores a crackdown on social media said to have helped looters during riots. The looters of London say they have no regrets and are enjoying the loot. Prakash Jha moves the Supreme Court after his film Arakshan is banned in 3 states, but the people's verdict is out. A key member of the CAG is accused of irregularities by the Shugru panel set up by the Prime Minister to probe the Commonwealth Games. As another top cop in Gujarat takes on the Modi government, the Home Minister says that the centre could intervene if approached. Millionaire horse breeder Hasan Ali gets bail from the Bombay High Court. He cannot leave the country. Gautam Gambhir says England deserve to be number one team. It may be easy to get there, but not too easy to stay there, says Gambhir. First up at this hour, a day after the mercy petition of Per Ariwalan was rejected, his mother, Arputamal, made an appeal to the Chief Minister. An emotional mother, Arputamal, said that her son was falsely implicated in the case based on the submission of a hawker. Now, she cried out that a fair trial was denied for her son. She said that while the death sentence of Nalini, the first accused in the case, was commuted, her son's mercy plea was not heeded by the president.
விசாரணையில் 8 ஆண்டு எடுத்துக்கினாங்க, யாரையும் கேட்கல, 26 பேருக்கும் தூக்குனாங்க. உச்ச நீதிமன்றம் போய் திருப்பும் தூக்கு உறுதி போய் இன்னைக்கு இன்ன நேற்றுல 6வது முறை எங்களை தூக்கில் போட்டிருக்காங்க. நேற்று அந்த தண்டனை உரிமைப்படுத்தின மூலம் நாங்கள் 6வது முறை தூக்கு போய் வந்துட்டோம். எங்கள் குடும்பம் பூரா துடிக்கிறோம். எதுக்கு எங்களுக்கு இது?
Well, these emotional cries have certainly raised the big question, and for more on that, it's over to Sanjay.
Welcome back. We've got in our studio America V. Narayanan, former headquarters secretary of the Tamil Nadu Congress, who's come here in his spotless white shirt and veshti to match your soul, is it?
Well, I want it to match this country's peacefulness.
All right, okay, fine. So talking of peace, I'll come back to you. And Mr. Raghavathaman, K. Raghavathaman, former chief investigating officer of the CBI, the Rajiv Gandhi assassination case. Thank you very much, sir, for coming. Always a pleasure to have you. Yeah. Mr. Narayan, if I can start off with you, since you spoke about peace.
Sure.
Why are you then baying for blood?
No, we are not caring for blood. We understand when a mother cries, we understand her cry. But it is one mother crying as opposed to millions of Indians crying. We want, as much as the mother feels for the child, we, the Indians, are feeling for the child of the nation, Rajiv Gandhi.
All right. Fair enough.
We, our hearts are crying as much as the mother heart is crying
Fair enough. The Congress workers' sentiments will be appreciated, but is that clouding your sense of judgment? Because don't forget that Sonia Gandhi, the wife of Rajiv Gandhi, was assassinated, herself pardoned Nalini and was instrumental in commuting the life, the death sentence to life imprisonment.
Well, that shows her bigger heart, and that's why we and India has accepted her as the leader. But this is, there has to be a justice, and the justice is a son of the soil, the prime minister of the country who could have taken this country so far ahead, not one soul, but has given the development for this country has been taken away in the prime of his life.
All
and
right.
There has to be a justice for that.
All right, we can now go across to our studio in the Hindu, where we are joined by Arputamal, the mother of Perarivalan. Amma, vanakkam. இப்போ வந்து எல்லா வாய்ப்பு வந்து ஏற்கனவே நீங்க யூஸ் பண்ணிட்டீங்க இப்போ எதனால நீங்க வந்து சொல்றீங்க உங்க பையனுக்கு இன்னும் நியாயம் கிடைக்கலன்னு
விட தெரியாத கேள்விகள் இதுல நிறைய இருக்கிறதா சொல்றாரு ரகோத்மன் தான் சொல்றாரு இன்னும் அந்த குண்டை வடிவமைச்சது யாரு எங்க கண்டு எங்க எடுத்தாங்க அப்படின்றத என்னால சொல்ல முடியல விடை காண முடியாத கேள்வின்னு சொல்றாரு அவரு தான் சொல்றாரு இதுல இன்வெஸ்டிகேஷன் பண்ண சிபிஐ அதிகாரி தான் சொல்றாரு அப்ப குண்டியே எங்க வடிவமைச்சாங்க யார் வடிவமைச்சாங்கன்னு கண்டுபிடிக்காத போது ரெண்டு பேட்டரி வாங்கி கொடுத்தானே என் பையனை தூக்குல போட்டுருவாங்களா
மிஸ்டர் ரகோத்மன் இந்திரா காந்தி இட்ஸ் எ டைரக்ட் சவாலஞ்ச் டு யூ பிகாஸ் சரி பா ஒரே நிமிஷம் நம்ம ரகோத்மன் ஐயா இங்க இருக்காரு நம்ம ஸ்டுடியோல பேர் அறிவாளன் இன் ஃபேக்ட் இஸ் யூ நோ வாஸ் நாட் அ மெயின் பிளேயர் ஆல்தோ யூ வில் கிளைம் தட் ஹி வாஸ் அ கோர் மெம்பர் யூ ஹேவ் ஐடென்டிஃபைட் ஹிம் பேஸ்ட் ஆன் த ஸ்டேட்மெண்ட் ஆஃப் அ வெண்டர் அண்ட் யூ ஹேவ் ஆல்சோ கோன் ஆன் ரெக்கார்ட் இன் தி மீடியா இன் தி பாஸ்ட் டு சே தட் தி சிபிஐ ஹட் நோ க்ளூ ஹஸ் ஷீ சேஸ் as to how the bomb was made.
Exactly.
Then why nail him?
See, it is not a question of telling that the mere purchase of a battery one man is hanged. Just because the purchase of battery is not being hanged. Let her mother answer. Where was Arivalan, Perarivalan, during 1991?
You ask her in Tamil.
Whether Unga Mahan, 91 May, ஜனவரி டிசம்பர் 90லேருந்து ஜனவரி 91 பிப்ரவரி 92 மார்ச் ஏப்ரல் மே உங்கள் மகன் எங்கே இருந்தார்னு உங்களுக்கு தெரியுமா உங்கள் மகன் எங்கே இருந்தார்னு தெரியுமா யார் வீட்டில் தங்கியிருந்தான்னு தெரியுமா
பேசுறாருங்க அனாவசியமா இவர் திசை திருப்புறாரு கண்டுபிடிக்கிட்டோம் முதல்ல அதை செய்யட்டோம் பாம் தயார் பண்ணது எங்கன்னு கண்டுபிடிக்கிட்டோம் அதுக்கப்புறம் என் பையனுக்கு தூக்கு கொடுக்கட்டோம் இதுல கண்டுபிடிக்க வேண்டியது நிறைய இருக்குது அதே பையனு சொல்லிட்டு எப்படி என் பையனுக்கு தூக்கு கொடுப்பாங்க என்ன ஏமா அந்த பெட்டி வச்சுட்டு இருக்கிறமா எல்லாரையும் தூக்கு கொடுக்கறதுக்கு கேட்கறதுக்கு ஆள் இல்ல பொலிட்டிக்கல் எங்க பக்கம் இல்லைன்றதுனால எங்க பையனு தூக்குல போட்டுருவாங்களா
சரி மிஸ் ரகோத்மன் யா தட்ஸ் த தட்ஸ் அங்குவேஷ் அண்ட் பெயின் ஆஃப் அ மதர் டாக்கிங் தேர் பட் இன்ஃபேக்ட் பிரபாகரன் இன் ஒன் ஆஃப் அட்லீஸ்ட் இட்ஸ் ரிப்போர்ட்டட் இன் ஒன் ஆஃப் த யூ நோ இன்டர்செப்ட்ஸ் that he said that only three people were aware of the assassination plot, including himself. There was Danu, the belt bomber, and Subha. So where did Perarivalan come into the picture then?
Yeah, see,
was he aware also?
No.
Also to take off from the mother's plea. Was he aware? Was Perarivalan aware, assuming that he indeed bought those two 9-volt batteries, was he aware that those batteries were for the bomb, belt bomb to kill Rajiv Gandhi?
Exactly.
Have you established that in your investigation?
Exactly. You see, as far as this case is concerned, in the beginning of the investigation, everybody knows, including the mother of Arivu, that who killed Rajiv Gandhi? 22nd, 23rd, 24th, 25th, 26th, up to 18th, 9th June, we were roaming in the darkness. And we never picked up Bhagyanathan or Padma or that Perarivalan. Only when we got hold of the camera, And then it came to know that it belonged to the Haribabu, the fellow who was unidentified body was lying there, in spite of the fact that he was having an identity card of Subhash Sundaram and another card of Ravi Shankar, that man from whom he brought the camera. And when the police rang up at the midnight and asked Subhash Sundaram whether this is a boy who belonged to him, he denied. And whether, when they rang up to that Ravi Shankar, father took Kamaraj, and he said he is very much here and he has gone to GH for taking photographs. And the body was claimed as unidentified, it was lying there. Then that was the, from Haribabu we went to his house, and when we searched his house, we found the role of Pagyanathan and Arivu, very close to Baby Subramanian.
What was the role?
That they were
convicted of criminal conspiracy, but what was the role exactly?
Exactly, in every part of the persons who is playing in this role.
No, what was Arivo's precise role in this case?
Precise role is, he is the right hand of Sivarasam, and he has purchased 9 volts battery, that is, leave alone that 9 volts battery, 12 volts battery for transmission of messages. Which is a lorry, batteries used for lorries.
That is established on record.
All then right. Motorcycle, which was used by Sivarasan. And he was helping them in all the ways, whatever is possible, not knowingly. That is the more important part of it. Not knowingly.
No, he did not know.
Listen to me.
No, he did not know.
He says aiding and abetting the crime with the full knowledge
of
the...
With the knowledge.
Okay, let me go across to Subramani.
That's what he's saying.
Oh, let me go across to Subramani. It's important to get Mr. A. Subramani here, who in fact is a veteran legal correspondent with the Hindu, then with the Times of India, and now of course is a lawyer practicing in the Madras High Court. Subramani, pleasure to have you as always. Do you believe, going by your extensive experience in legal reportage, and also now your experience in practice at the bar, that there should be a time frame to decide clemency, please?
Of course, yes. There has to be a time frame. See, Article 72, under which the president and governor exercise their exclusive discretionary power to commute sentence or remit or suspend the sentence. There has to be a time frame. Otherwise, a person who has sent in the mercy plea, a clemency petition, is made to wait for, in this case, see, they sent it in 1998, and so 13 years, and no answer. I mean, every day was a death for them. And a time frame within which they have to dispose of the petition, either this way or that way. To be followed with, whether to hang them or to release them, it should happen within a time frame. I mean, making them to wait endlessly, takes no one anywhere.
So, that's an important point you're raising, Subramani. I want to bring in Mr. America Narayanan, because there are people like Kolathur Mani who said that they will protest if a Tamil is hanged, and also there are people from the Congress who say that they will protest if they don't go ahead with the sentencing. Now, I want to quote from a Supreme Court judgment. In fact, this was in the Triveni Bend versus State of Gujarat, where the Supreme Court said, "The anguish of alternating hope and despair, the agony of uncertainty, the consequences of such suffering on the mental, emotional and physical state of an individual has to be taken into account." And also talks about Article 21, that if you're going to take away someone's life, that process should be fair, just and reasonable till the last breath of life. Do you believe that putting a person inside, making him wait for years on end to decide his mercy plea is fair, just and reasonable?
Well, there are two views of points on this. I would like to share both the viewpoint. One, it is understandable. Justice delayed is just denied. And particularly when a person is going through this harrowing experience, but we need to keep in mind the kind of crime he committed, not only against the humanity, another human being, but the nation. The heinous crime he has committed, we need to take that into consideration, how he not only affected individual, but the country itself. Now, the delay in justice is also because thousands of innocents, even one innocent person should not be punished. That's why the justice system takes long. So, the criminal system in this country, not only in this country, anywhere in the world, does take a significant amount of delay. But we can have a fast court system. And that's being talked about not only in the cases like this, but also in the corruption cases. And I think in our country, we need to increase the speed of delivering the justice.
No, but in this particular case, here's a mother who's making a point. For so long, she says, our family has been hanged
but
six times.
But who has been asking clemency? She could have just let her son hang, but she wanted to go through every procedure. It is the lawyers who are.
She's entitled to it. She's entitled to that as a citizen.
That's right. So
remember that Per Ariyavalan, unlike Murugan or Santhan, who are Sri Lankans, Per Ariyavalan is an Indian.
So what? No, it's more the reason. He's not only has helped them, he's a traitor. He has betrayed his own country, for God's sake.
No, but then
it's a worse crime than the other two guys who are Sri Lankans. They are only, at least, they have killed another national. He has killed our own brother.
All right.
Our own leader.
Mr. Subramani, okay, strong words here coming from Mr. America Narayanan, the congressman that he is. We can understand the Congress sentiments here, but really, what are Per Ariyavalan's legal options right now? Can he then make a fresh mercy plea? If it's a fresh mercy plea, will the fresh mercy plea act as a sort of stay, in a sense, against the execution of the death sentence?
Yeah, he has
two options now, Sanjay. See, what we are talking about is clemency, not amnesty.
Yes.
See, he is in jail for 21 years now. So, no one asked for his pardon. So, still now that his mercy petition has been dismissed, rejected, he has two options. One, he can represent the petition. There is no limit. There is no cap on the number of times you can prefer such petition. Just as the absence of a time frame is bad. I mean, it's equally bad. There's no time limit. There's no number of no limit on the number of times you can present such petitions. So, all three can very well present a new petition and await the outcome. But mere fact that they were represented a new petition will not stop anyone. Need not stop anyone from taking this rejection to a logical conclusion unless it is stayed. So, this is where. Under Article 226, President's power can be questioned. In fact, 72, under which the President exercises her power, has certain strings attached to it. 72(4) clearly says, if her decision is arbitrary or malafide or irrelevant, in this case, these three can invoke the second part, that is arbitrariness. They can say we are in jail for 21 years and that's like undergoing one life term. Anything beyond 14 years is considered one life term. Although courts have written.
Double jeopardy in a sense, because already you want almost undergone like a life term and then you want to be hanged.
Yes. You have to spend the entire life term in jail. That's what courts have many times said. But still. Prematurely have been given even as early as after 7.5 years happened in Tamil Nadu itself. So, making them spend 21 years in jail is like making them spend one lifetime in jail, then again hanging them. So, there one difference could be being punished twice for same offense. One. Second one is, mitigating circumstances like their age. Ariyavalan was not even 20, I think barely 20 when he went to jail. And he's in prime of his youth and he showed good conduct throughout his jail term. So, citing all these reasons, they can move court and there was a good chance of getting some interim order. But without any interim order and without any review of the presidential decision to reject their mercy plea, it's tough. But
let me bring in Mani. I get your point, Mr. Raghavathaman. Again, Nalini, who had a much bigger role in the assassination, that's what the court had ruled. Her death sentence has been commuted to life imprisonment. Now she's even seeking release from prison. But somebody who had a relatively less role to play in this now faces the gallows. Doesn't that go against the principles of natural justice?
You see, when you look at
justice should not only be done, but also
to be done. It appeared to be done. I fully agree with you. But when you see the judgment where Justice K.T. Thomas deferred
there was a dissenting opinion
that he was not for hanging Mrs. Nalini. Hmm. For the one reason, she was present at the scene of crime.
Hmm.
Section 34 applies to her, and whatever the other accused does, automatically it comes on her.
Also, they didn't want her child then to be made an officer because Murugan was also sentenced.
That is not at all a consideration for a Supreme Court consider. Actually, she was more involved, and she was very much involved in this case.
So, but how does it to a mother, to a person like Peraravel, like Arumathamal, if Nalini is now seeking release, her commutation, her son is now the rejection of the mercy plea, which means he faces the gallows. So how fair is that to her?
I tell you, the same Peraravalan has put a mercy petition before the governor of Tamil Nadu, along with Nalini. And why the government of Tamil Nadu at that time decided to go to give a mercy petition to consider only for Nalini, and why not these three? That time itself, they could have considered for Peraravalan also. The mother would have made a hue and cry at that time itself when she was granted these things.
There's an element of finality with this.
See, she was given a lot of opportunity. The accused was given a lot of opportunity. The mercy petition was before the governor of Madras, and the government of Tamil Nadu advised her to consider the case of only for Nalini, and the other three, they rejected it. Then only they went to the President of India. It is not that they have straight away gone to the President of India. They went to the governor. And the government of Tamil Nadu at that time, they have considered it. And then again, now they have considered it's a fit case for, conviction.
What do you personally believe as a chief investigating officer? If you were to cast aside your role as a prosecutor in this case, as an investigator in this case, do you believe Peraravalan, given your extensive investigation of this case, deserves to die?
You see, as far as an investigating officer concerned or of the investigating officer concerned, as rightly put it, a national leader is killed in this case. You must keep it in mind. It is not an X and Y you are talking about it. It is a national leader. I am sorry I have put the question. She doesn't know where his son was and what he was doing. And she doesn't know what his son was doing it. And she is telling that she has done nothing. He has not done it. I am not questioning her because she is mother. I fully with her. Now listen. Now, when we come across
evidence. Let's give her. Ningi solunga ma.
Rajiv Gandhi uyiro, yen paiyan uyiro, enna vyathasam iruka?
Nichayama
iruka. Ippa ye onnu Nalini. Ava thandana korappu seidirukranga andha edathil irundhavulukku. Appa pen uyir aan uyir neenga vyathasam paakkrangala? அப்ப சட்டத்துக்கு முன் அனவை உயிரும் சமான்னு சொல்றது எதுக்கு? நீதி எல்லாருக்கும் சமான்னு சொல்றது அப்ப ஏமாத்து வேலையா? A18 என் பையன் அவ எப்படி இன்னும் மரண தண்டிலேயே இருப்பான்? A1 நளினி அப்ப பெண்ணுனா அவளுக்கு வந்து இலக்கம் காட்டின தண்டனை குறைக்கணும்னு சொல்றாங்க. அது எப்படி சட்டத்துக்கு அடங்கும்? எப்படி பெட்டிஷன் போட்டாங்க கவர்னர் கிட்ட அவளுங்க தள்ளிட்டு நளினி எடுத்துக்கினாங்கன்னு இந்த சிபிஐ அதிகாரி சொல்றாரு. ஏன் இவருக்கு சொல்ல தெரியாதா? கொலை பண்ணவங்களுக்கு தான் மரண தண்டனை கொடுத்துருக்கணும்ன்றாங்க. பேட்டரி வாங்கி கொடுத்தவன், இதை வாங்கி கொடுத்தான், அதை வாங்கி கொடுத்தான்னு எஜ்ஜு கட்டி பேசுறவங்களுக்குலாம் ஒரு மரண தண்டனையா? அப்ப கொலை செய்யறவங்களுக்கு என்ன தண்டனை கொடுத்துருப்பாங்க? கண்டுபிடிச்சிருந்தாங்கல்ல, இல்ல கொலை ஏற்பாடு பண்ணவங்களை தண்டிச்சிட்டாங்களா? இன்னைக்கு வரைக்கும் கேள்வியா இருக்குது யாருன்னு. இப்ப எழுதுறான் சந்திரசாமியை தண்டிக்கணும்னு. இதுக்கெல்லாம் இந்த சிபிஐ அதிகாரி என்ன பதில் சொல்வாரு? இவரே சொல்லிக்கிறாரு பேட்டியில, நான் கலைஞரெல்லாம் வந்து பேட்டி எடுக்கணும்னு கேட்டேன், அவரெல்லாம் வந்து இன்வெஸ்டிகேஷன் பண்ணணும்னு சொன்னேன், உயர் அதிகாரி கார்த்திகேயன் மறுத்துட்டாருன்னு. இத்தனை பேர் சந்தேகம் இவருக்கே இருக்கு. அப்புறம் என் பையனை தூக்கில போறது முன்னாள் பிரதமர், முன்னாள் பிரதமர் எத்தனை நாளைக்கு சொல்லுவாங்க? அப்ப முன்னாள் பிரதமர் உயிரும் என் பையன் உயிரும்
ஒண்ணுதான். ஒரே நிமிஷம் அப்புறத்தமால, ஒரே நிமிஷம், உங்க ஒரு அம்மானால உங்க வேதனை புரியுது. அடுத்த கட்ட நடுவே என்ன என்ன பண்ண போறீங்கம்மா? சட்டப்படியா என்ன பண்ண போறீங்க
அடுத்தது?
சொல்லுங்க, நீங்க சொல்லுங்க.
நான் இவங்க கருண மனு நிராகரிச்சுட்டு இது உறுதிப்படுத்திட்டதுனால நான் இப்ப எங்க முதல்வர் அம்மாவுக்கு நான் வந்து வேண்டுகோள் வைக்க போறேன். இது வந்து முற்றிலும் தவறான முடிவு. இது நாங்க வந்து இப்ப தண்டனை குறைப்பு செய்வாங்க, அப்ப தண்டனை குறைப்பு செய்வாங்க. 12 ஆண்டு காலம் என் பையன் வந்து மரண தண்டனை சிறைவாசியாவே இருந்து நொந்து நொந்து அவன் செத்தது பத்தாத எங்க குடும்பம் பூரா இதே நாங்களும் சாகிறோம் அவனோட. இதோட 6வது முறை அவனுக்கு வந்து உறுதி செய்தாங்க. நாங்க 6 முறை செத்து செத்து பழைச்சோம். இதெல்லாம் முன் வச்சு நீங்க எப்படியாவது தாய் உள்ளத்தோட கருணை கொண்டு இதை வந்து சட்டமன்றத்தில் ஒரு தீர்மானம் கொண்டு வந்து என் பையனுக்கு கண்டிப்பா வந்து தண்டனை குறைப்பு செய்யறதுக்கு மறுபரிசீலனை செய்து அவனை எப்படியாவது நீங்க விடுவிச்சு இந்த வயசான காலத்திலேயாவது என் ஒரு மகனை எனக்கு திருப்பி கொடுக்கணும். ஆனா அவன் மனசறிஞ்சு உண்மையிலேயே இந்த கொலையில ஈடுபட்டானான்றத எல்லாரும் மனசாட்சி தொட்டு சொல்லணும். சும்மா வீணா இது ராஜீவ்காந்தி முன்னாள் ராஜீவ்காந்தின்லாம் யார் மேலேயும் பழி வைக்க கூடாது. இதை வாங்கி கொடுத்தா அதை வாங்கி கொடுத்தான்னு சொல்றாரு. பெல்ட் பாம் தயார் பண்ணது யாருன்னு கண்டுபிடிக்கல. அப்ப இதுக்கு மேல என் பையனை தூக்கல் போட்ட பின்னாடி பெல்ட் பாம் தயாரிச்சது யாருன்னு கண்டுபிடிச்சு அவங்களுக்கு திருப்பும் தூக்கல ஏத்துவாங்களா? ஏன்னா தூக்குன்னா என்ன சாதாரணமா? என் பையன் தவறு செய்தான்னு சொல்ற
We understand the sentiments. I mean, that's a mother, you know, speaking. I mean, her son faces the prospect of death.
Absolutely.
But the point that she's making is that we still haven't answered that on the show here.
Yes.
That he had a lesser role compared to the others. Those who've had a greater role are even seeking release. We don't want to go into the merits of that right now. Why should somebody who's played perhaps what you call an ancillary role in this case be given the death penalty? Because the death penalty is for the rarest of rare cases. What is his role? The gravity of the offense.
See,
the punishment should fit the crime.
Mr. Pinto, listen. The role played by the each accused has been weighed on the basis of the evidence placed before the apex court.
And proved beyond reasonable doubt.
Beyond reasonable doubt. It is the rarest of rare case only they will invoke. Rarest of rare case. Out of 26 accused, why should they select this Perarivalan and Murugan and Santhan? Why should they select?
Yeah, the court in their wisdom
Appreciation of evidence.
Yeah, okay.
Appreciation of evidence.
Absolutely.
And appreciation of evidence is by the judge and not by us. Our job is only to collect it and place it.
And it's the third level.
I am not here to punish him. And we are not the authority recommend even hanging sentence, all the things. But
do you feel sorry for him? Do you feel sorry for a man, if assuming that is correct, that he indeed went to procure batteries, that he should face, does he deserve the death penalty for that?
You see, it is not a question of...
If I may interrupt you once again. You keep saying that he has gone out to procure a battery.
This is what is reported and this is...
No, the bottom line is, he has killed the future of the country. He has killed the son who has brought this country to the 21st century and would have taken this country much faster, much better. He has not only killed an individual, he killed the hope, he killed the development, he killed the poor people who could have gotten further in this country. He has been a traitor.
Did he do it himself?
Whether he did it himself or with the accomplices is not the question. The courts, not only the Supreme Court, but it's a third level court, Apex Court, which has reviewed the case, is very clear that he deserves this beyond reasonable doubt. Let us not redo the trial here in the media today.
No, we're not. We're not
now
even
what
attempting
I am,
that.
What I do want to tell you is it has been very clear that the courts, it has been done in the media, but the courts has gone through case by case based on the CBI and other
There are media
evidences.
People who are witnesses also. There were media people who are present
I know,
who are also witnesses
But what I'm trying
case.
To say is I don't want to redo the trial here. What the answer, the real question is, does he deserve this? I think absolutely yes. But I understand. I understand the mother's feeling. I can see how her heart cries. But she needs to understand millions of hearts crying for Rajiv Gandhi.
All right. One final question that we can go back to Subramani. Subramani, as a legal expert, do you believe that the president's decision to reject the mercy plea should be subject to judicial review? Do you believe that? Because these are grey areas. Subramani?
Sorry, it was not audible. Can you repeat?
Yeah. Do you believe that the president's decision to reject the mercy, the clemency plea, should be subject to judicial review? Because it's still a grey area.
It's not grey area, Sanjay. Article 72(4) clearly says, if there is any doubt of malafide or arbitrary or irrelevant considerations in this exercise of power, it can be reviewed by the High Court, 236. So, it's not at all a grey area. They have a clear option to challenge it before the High Court.
In this particular case, given the facts and circumstances of the case, do you believe that this is a fit case for a review, of judicial review of the presidential order?
Any such decision is reviewable, not because it's Rajiv Gandhi, not because it is Perarivalan or Santhan. Anyone whose clemency plea has been rejected has every right to invoke 72(4) and approach High Court or the Supreme Court for remedy. So, it's not at all a grey area. That's one possible option for them to get this presidential rejection review and get some remedy. If they deserve it. But the court can't go into the merit of the order, president's order, but it can definitely subject the manner in which it is exercised under, it can put it under judicial scrutiny.
All right.
The manner of exercise of this power, it can be reviewed.
All right. Thank you very much, Subramani, for joining us. Also, Arpathamal, Numa Nandri Amma, Ninga Vande, நம்ம தொலைக்காட்சியில் வந்து கலந்துருக்கீங்க, ரொம்ப நன்றி. ஃபைனல் கமெண்ட்ஸ் ஃப்ரம் த டூ ஜென்டில்மேன். யா
சி ஐ வாண்ட் இட் வெல் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் திங் இஸ் பை ப்ரொலாங்கிங் இட் டேக்கிங் இட் டு சுப்ரீம் கோர்ட் அகெயின் யூ ஆர் ஒன்லி ப்ரொலாங்கிங் தி அகனி ஆஃப் த ஜென்டில்மேன் அண்ட் த லேடி ஹர் ஹிஸ் மதர். I think on earlier you said, are we really doing this justice to the person who is convicted and is sending to the gallows by delaying it? I think anybody who does it is really bringing more agony to that person. Second, I understand the agony of the mother, but the agony of the nation has to be answered. This also has to be a deterrent for anybody who comes to India and tries to take away our leader.
Mr. Gautaman?
See, as far as this case is concerned, I am not here to comment on the...
None of us are, yeah.
About the decision of government or anything like that. But as a general public, I feel...
reported also that he's the manner...
The mild mannered nature of the young man
in prison.
He
went in at the prime of his life at 19.
I am not on the subject. Once a Supreme Court has confirmed the death sentence, there should be time limit for clemency petition or disposal.
Yeah.
This is my
some agreement.
After all, it has to be decided by the court. The evidentiary value has to be analyzed by the court, not by anybody else. What is presented in the court, that is the evidence. And they have taken a decision. And that decision is subjected to the clemency. There is a possibility, a provision has been made in the constitution that you can go to the mercy petition. The mercy petition also has been dismissed. It should be within a framework of the period. And it should not be longer indefinite. And as the Subramaniam said, it is agony for everyone.
We cannot get carried away, we cannot get swayed by emotions, because ultimately the fundamental premise that they teach you in law school is that law is reason without passion.
Yes.
Thank you very much, Mr. Gautaman and Mr. Narayanan, for joining us in our studio.
Thank
well,
you.
Stay tuned to NDTV Hindu, because Ashmit Kumar is going to come up with a lot more news on this bulletin, which will extend till 10 o'clock.